So not too long ago, I talked about Spawn in my last Metal World Order review. I talked about the Iced Earth concept album, The Dark Saga. Well, I figured I would review a Spawn video game. So the full name of this game is Todd McFarlane's Spawn, the video game, but I'm just going to call it Spawn the video game because it's simple. The game was developed by Yukitoe Company and published by Acclaim and Sony Electronic Publishing. It was released in 1995 on the Super Nintendo and was not released on anything else. You play as Al Simmons, or Spawn. If you know the story behind on how Al becomes Spawn, well, it's not hard to read the origins. Pretty interesting, really. And if you remember in my Metal World Order review, I talked about the song I Died For You and the lyrics behind that song. That kind of sets the origins a bit. So many kids have been kidnapped and Spawn is out to save them, pretty much. 13 kids, to be exact. One of them is Spawn's stepdaughter, and their souls are locked in a magical orb called the Orb of Purity. The Mad One has a goal to use the Orb of Purity to destroy them, the male Belogia, once and for all. You must stop the Mad One to save yourself, your stepdaughter, and other children. You will go through up to 17 levels with a variety of enemies and bosses. And as you can see, the game is a side-scrolling beat-em-up slash platformer. You can walk, run, duck, jump, attack with punching and kicking, and you have special powers that require special button input combinations. Using the special powers will drain your life, so you have to use it wisely. You can fire projectiles, teleport, and refill your life meter as well. You can replenish health by collecting items dropped by the bosses when they are defeated. Now, if your life bar goes completely empty, it's game over, or if the in-game timer runs out. Luckily, there is unlimited continues, and you can play on the same level. You don't have to start at the beginning, which is really nice. If you choose to take a break, there is a password system that allows you to come back to that spot, but the amount of life gone when you were at that spot will still be there. It will not refill, so I guess you could say that kind of fucks you over a little bit. The graphics for Spawn are pretty damn nice. The level designs are good. The enemies, which are usually thugs and robots and all that type of shit, are great. Some have knives, guns, some take two hits, and some just take one. The bosses look great. The sprites of Spawn look very well detailed for 16-bit. The game is very colorful, and the colors are in the right places. The little cutscenes you see, which are pictures, are really cool. It helps tell the story as well. The game doesn't slow down or glitch. The game doesn't flicker. At least I didn't really see any of them. The animations ranging from the bosses and so on look very well done. I'm actually really impressed with how this game looks. A lot of time went into it. The music, I love it. I think it's really, really well done. It might sound a little bit on the low quality side, but it's well composed and it's enjoyable to listen to. Not only that, it fits the game perfectly. The sound effects from the fighting noises, gunfire, explosions, and everything is good. The controls, well, they're playable. Attacking is easy, same with blocking. Doing special moves can be a little bit on the frustrating side as you have to hit a certain button combination. There are times that I feel that the game is a little slow at responding, especially when jumping to avoid an attack. Let's say from a boss or jumping to attack an enemy that is higher up. The wall jumping part can be a little frustrating as well, but after a while you get the hang of it. Definitely not horrible, but it does have flaws, that is for sure. Spawn the video game on the Super Nintendo is not bad at all. Could use some work, but if you're a fan of Spawn, you may enjoy the hell out of it. The story is great, the gameplay is nice, it's a beat-em-up with platformer elements to it, pretty simple to understand. The graphics are well done and run smooth, the music is enjoyable, as well as the sound effects. The game can be difficult in some spots, like some of the boss battles, but I'm perfectly fine with that, although it was frustrating at the time of recording footage. And on top of that, I feel that the hit detection can be a little bit off. The controls, though, are probably the biggest issue, and it's not the movement or attacking, but like I said, it's more so the jumping. But I can't say this game is awful. Some have said it's just a beat-em-up with the Spawn name and enemy slapped on it. I think it's more than that, and I had a lot of fun playing the game. Now, the game was not released on any virtual console or anything like that. Obviously, the Spawn character copyright, and that's kind of a damn shame. But the game is 28% rare, and prices on eBay range from $12.50, $16.99, $10.95, $99.99 for a complete in box, and that's fucking ridiculous, $11.50, $6.99, and prices in between. Not bad. Obviously, the $10 to $15 range is fine, but if you can find the game cheaper, then go for it. Now, of course, this is not the only game to feature the Spawn character. There was Spawn the Eternal on the PlayStation, Spawn on the Game Boy Color, Spawn in the Demon's Hand for arcade and Sega Dreamcast, and the last game, Spawn Armageddon for the Nintendo GameCube, PlayStation 2, and the original Xbox. I'm kind of surprised there hasn't been a new game. I think it would be pretty badass if there was one on current gen consoles and PC, if done right. I hope you enjoyed this review of Spawn the video game for the Super Nintendo. Thanks for watching.